Okay, here's your Craftsman. So this one's got this plastic carburetor on it. You can buy these plastic carburetors for about 10 or 15 bucks on Amazon. What holds it in is this faceplate here. And then this carburetor just slides out. And one thing you gotta be careful of is right in between here, there's a little bitty gasket. It's an O-ring. Sometimes when you pull this out, the O-ring will fall off or something. Or it'll stick to the carburetor. When you pull the carburetor out to look at it, then it'll fall off somewhere. Just make sure you realize there's going to be an O-ring right in between there, between the carburetor and the head. And this thing has these two screws here on the top. They're the Torx style. And it's got this little thing here where you push in. Basically, if you look at it, you can see there's a little clip right there. That clip, basically, take it like something to stick in there and then push this way. And then that clip will release so you can pull this off. So you need to pull this off so that you can hook the whatever this carburetor PCV tube back on. So that little PVC tube needs to go back on this air cleaner. And these carburetors are actually fairly easy to take apart and clean. This one, I couldn't see anything wrong with it. It's got a little problem with the starting, but there's other videos online as well on how to replace or rebuild the carburetor. Like I said, these carburetors are only about 10 bucks online, so it might be just as easy to replace the carburetor. What I usually do on these, because the fuel line's connected to this carburetor, so basically what I do is I tip it to the side. So I'll lift this up a couple, like a foot or so up, so we've got a little tip on this, or tip it back this way, whichever way. We avoid the pressure from the gas line, and or use a vice grip, and then pinch off the line so the gas don't run out. So that's your tip for today. Thanks for watching. If you need any help, you can contact me, 707-443-8347 Pacific Time.